Pride is like Christmas. It's the happiest day of the year.
It's all about inclusiveness.
It's a family day. Everybody comes out. It's a fun day.
It's the best way to spend my birthday.
Call it what you want. Pride season is here. And this summer, Outlooks TV has got you covered. Yeah! We're hitting the road to show you the best that Pride has to offer in five Canadian cities. The people, the parties, the politics.
Trans rights now!
One national Pride tour.
Fantastic.
Which brings us to the second stop on our tour, the beautiful city of Vancouver. Over the course of its 34-year history, Vancouver Pride has grown to attract more than 650,000 people, making it one of the top five Pride events in the world. The festival runs from June to August, ending with a week of events made possible by some 500 volunteers.
Well, it's very much bringing people together to celebrate, but at the same time, starting conversations, starting debates about how do we make a better future and a better tomorrow for our community.
Vancouver Pride is awesome. It's really good. There's so many people. It's great that we have our own gay village, the Davie Street Village.
Vancouver's Pride Parade, the largest LGBT celebration in Western Canada.
It's fabulous. The weather, the people, this is an amazing city to be in.
At one end of the march, you have two NHL hockey players. At the other end, a transgender beauty queen, encouraging people to embrace their individuality. None of the three have ever been to a Pride parade, and while they might as well come from different worlds, today, they've marched as one.
You know, we're happy to be here and happy to support the parade.
Jason Garrison and Manny Malhotra of the Vancouver Canucks marched to support a campaign called You Can Play, which aims to eliminate homophobia in sports.
As an athlete, you want to be judged on how well you play the game. It's time to drop all these taboo questions of gays in sports. It's, you know, it shouldn't be an issue at all.
All Jenna Talakova wanted was to be judged by her modeling skills, not by her gender identity. The 23-year-old from Vancouver drew international attention after she was disqualified from this year's Miss Universe pageant for not being, quote, a natural-born female. The decision was later reversed. Talakova competed and made the top 12.
Everybody should embrace their individuality. That's what I did in the pageant, and you know, it got me this far.
As one of this year's parade marshals, Talakova looks forward to being a role model for young people.
I'm going to bring a lot more awareness to high schools because I feel like that's where I had most of my trouble.
Locals will agree, the Pride Parade is the place to make a statement.
My girlfriend Ali opened the very first Pride Parade in Vancouver.
Wearing a wedding dress.
In 1981. Before that we had marches and stuff, but we didn't have, weren't allowed to walk on the street or the police would arrest you and throw you in a paddy wagon.
Today you're more likely to be thrown into an event where partying meets politics.
What's going on down here? We're yelling at the conservatives.
Why are you yelling at the conservatives?
Because they're anti-gay, anti-women, anti-choice.
We're proud to be Canadians, we're proud to be conservatives, and we're proud to support the community.
I think I'm the only federal party leader who made it this year, so I had to wear the double boa.
The Pride Parade comes to an end down here at Beach and Jervis on the waterfront, and then it turns into a community fair in gorgeous Sunset Beach Park.
High school water, get your high school water.
There's so many different groups here from every single part of the community. I used to live in Toronto, and Vancouver's a much smaller city population-wise, but it definitely brought it.
Okay, well, I can't think of a better way to end the day than having a dance-off on the beach. Look at these guys. You guys are great! Thanks for watching our coverage of Vancouver Pride, and stay tuned as we'll be bringing you more Pride coverage all summer long. For Outlooks TV, I'm Michael Piak. All right, break it down!
I'm trying not to lose my head. It's like a jungle sometimes. It makes me wonder how I keep from going under.